This is 1 Corinthians 15 and verse 1. Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you, which all ye received and were and wherein ye stand. Verse 2. By which also ye are saved. Do you hear that? By which also ye are saved. By the what? The gospel. The prophecies are coming to pass. If ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. First and foremost, giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh. Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rakaha, Kwadash. Double honors to the men at Great Millstone, of whom I learn from each and every day. Healthy shalom to the brothers that are out there doing the work in truth and sincerity. It's the brother Gabar Dama coming back at you, you know, with another epistle, man. And hopefully it's edifying. I want to show you this right quick, you know, right quick, fast, and in a hurry. It was dope. It was dope as AF. I'll say it like that. Super dope, man. You know, and I got this clip from the elder Yashawamba. Check it out. Because this is about, really, you know, it's a gospel of good news, man. And the good news is what? That Israel shall be saved. World without end, as it says in the book of Isaiah, the 45. Does it not say that? It says Israel shall be saved. World without end. So these wacky, tacky ass Christians, you know, Galatians 3, verse 28. John 3:16, I'm not going to say they don't understand the context. I'm going to say they don't understand the scriptures at all. So check this out, man. This is very dope. All right. Because this really, you know, that's what we are waiting and patiently waiting for, is salvation. Remember, the scripture said the saints of the Most High shall do what? Take the kingdom. Stay tuned. My phone had to chime on now. That was super dope, and I really enjoyed watching that. I really did. It was a really good intro. All right, so I looked this up, you know, just curious, because I remember, I think it was this Nostradamus guy, which they, really, a prophet just means to tell you before. All right, prophesy, right? Because some people prophesy lies, some people prophesy the truth, and that's, you know, the children of Israel. I.e. the men at Great Millstone and some, and, you know, affiliate camps and, you know, and other brothers that teach the like-minded doctrine. And it's the same thing, you know, one body. Anyway, I looked this up because I had did a video about this before, and I believe it was this guy, Nostradamus, that in one of his quatrains, I think they called them quatrains, okay, that he had said something about in the latter days, there's going to be prophets that stand up and teach doom and gloom. Right. And teach the truth. Now, you know, you had Donald Trump talking about the prophets of doom. All right. And when really he was talking about us. OK, he was talking about us. He was. All right. But, you know, in that speech, I think was it the World Economic Forum or something like that? I'll pull it up here later. You know, he wasn't per se talking about us, but afterwards, he'd said something else. The elder from South Carolina, man, the elder, not Yashawamba, Salakia, the elder from South Carolina. Damn, why's his name just elude me right now? That's crazy. Monatnazak, damn. Salakia for that. That's crazy. All right. Yeah, he did a video about that. I think it was last week or so. Anyway, I pulled this up. This is what it says. And the reason why I read that scripture in the first place, the first scripture, is because these prophecies are what? Comforting to the elect. Because we know these, it's all about the elect anyway. He had care for his elect. That's who he's coming back to save. That's who, you know, that's why that clip was dope as hell, man. Straight up. No, there's going to be no reason for us to teach each other, because his law, statutes, and commandments are going to be put in our inward parts. And it's going to be perfect, just like it's supposed to be. All right? French astrologer, there go my phone again. French astrologer Nostradamus. 8 terrifying predictions for 2024. This is just 1 year. All right, for 2024 now, Elder Apostle Tahar coined this year, hopeful year of Jacob's trouble. And all these prophecies are coming to pass. All right, there's only several prophecies that are left anyway. And a lot of these prophecies, which Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai has put in our mind, our hearts, to go out and tell you and give you warning, are happening right in front of your eyes. That's another thing that wacky, tacky ass Christians never speak about is the throne of David. They don't, you know, and if they talk about the kingdom, they talk about it in a context that everybody can be saved and it's going to be, everything going to be nice. And it's going to be slaves in the kingdom. All right. It's going to be people under subjection that cannot wiggle their way out of nothing. All right. And, none of their enchantments are going to be able to stand. You understand that? All right. Let's read this. The French astrologer. Monthly prognosticator. You never know. He could have been an Israelite. I'm just saying. A lot of the stuff he so-called predicted, prophesied about has came true. All right. The French astrologer had made a number of predictions about the future, many of which have come to pass. Right. Let's see. French astrologer, of course, Nostradamus, is said to have foretold some of the world's biggest historical moments, and these are prophetical moments. This is about the prophecies. Didn't the scripture say all these things must come to pass? Not will or maybe, it said must. It's going to happen. All right. Before his death in 1566, Nostradamus made a number of predictions about the future, many of which have come to pass. He's been credited. Of course, he's been credited with predicting, I'll say it like that. Because, you know, the people who you can't criticize for some reason are claiming to be the people of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Ain't that something? That's a whole nother lesson. We go into it all the time anyway. Damn them people. Anyway, rise to the power of assassination of JFK, right? The September, 9-1-1, right? Got to be careful. I don't really give a damn, though. I really don't give a shit, to be honest. Anyway, T-word attacks. And CV 19er. Okay, this is very interesting. He's not been called the prophet of doom. Now hold on. Now didn't Donald Trump say don't listen to the prophets of doom who want to do nothing but what? Take over. That's what he said. We'll get the clip. All right. For nothing, if his prophecies are too believed. Believed the news for 2024 is not good. You hear that? It's not good. But wait a minute. The scripture said what? These words are comforting to us. These prophecies are comforting, knowing what's to come to pass. Remember, what did it say? Esau is the end of the world and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. And that's the kingdom. That's why I wanted to play that clip, man. It's super dope, man. I love that shit. Straight up. All right. According to his 1555 text, less prophecies, is that word again, the prophecies 2024 will come to bring war, famine, disaster, and turmoil. Do you hear this? But you know what? The Bible said this. The Bible said that prophets will stand up and tell you about these things before they come to pass, to give you warning from Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. So you can repent and turn back before it's too late, because there is a point in time where it's going to be too late. Let's continue on. According to Nostradamus, prophesies, right? The climate crisis only worsened in 2024. The dry earth will grow more parched. All right. And we saw examples of that. What was it? 2023. Yeah, it was 2024 also. You know, you had these certain rivers that resemble Egypt. huh? In Babylon, aka America, drying up. All right, what's that famous dam? Was it Nelson Hoover Dam? No, it's in Utah. Anyway, I forget what dam it was. All that it was a big ass lake, man made lake. All that was drying up. All right. See, all these things are happening, man. And the scripture said it well before Nostradamus. All right. I'm just going, through this just a little bit. Very great famine. All right. Through pestiferous. I don't know what that word means. I might want to look that up. Wave suggests extreme weather and widespread hunger. And the scripture said that, too. Let me look this word up right quick. Because I'm not sure how it's pronounced. Let's get the definition of that word. How's this pronounced? Pestiferous. All right.
Pestiferous.
Harboring infection and disease. Do you hear that? And you heard what the gates of hell said. Oh, they'll pay attention to the next one with a crooked ass Edomite smile on his face, right? Matter of fact, my whole family had something. I don't know what the hell it was, but it was kicking ass not a week ago, man. All right. And the last whatever the hell I had was totally different than that CV19er. It was totally different, man. That shit, I don't know what it is, man. Esau Edom is tearing this earth up, man. The scripture told you he'd take peace from the earth. All right? Yo, man, shit, that brings me to the clip already again. Kahalo Yahabah Shem Yahusha, man. All right? We're going to play it in a minute anyway. Consulting or pest or nuisance, annoying. And that's Esau in general. He's a damn nuisance. He's a pest, and he needs to be taken off this earth, man. Okay? So I looked this word up, prophetic. Prophetic, all right?
Prophetic.
Accurately describing or predicting what will happen in the future. That's exactly what we're telling you. And again, a lot of these things are happening. You don't hear these wacky, tacky Christians talking about the end of the world and, you don't hear them talking about, some of them, but you don't hear them talking about the MOTB. You don't hear them talking about none of this. You don't hear them talking about the kingdom of heaven, the throne of David, and how it's going to be taken, all right? And it's going to be ruled over with a rod of iron with a two-edged sword in their hand by the hands of my people, remember? You don't hear these people talking about that shit. You don't hear them talking about the prophecies. You know, it's all lovey-dovey, and that's all it is. According to their emotions, man, all right? And your emotions... And what you think and what you feel is going to get your ass killed, man. All right. Two, relating to characteristic of a prophet or a prophecy. Let's go here. Look the word up, prophecy. What does it mean? A prediction. All right. And through the faith of Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai, that he's given, that's the hell of a gift that he's given us. We know for a fact these things are coming down the pipe. The MOT is coming, MOTB is coming down the pipe, which is the C-HIP. Very clearly, it's easy to see it. Okay? We know Jacob's trouble's coming. We understand that part. We know there's wars and rumors of wars. We know the third woe is right there on the doorstep. That's a part of the prophecies. And what did he tell us to do? The book of Sirach 39, verse 1. But he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High and is occupied in the meditation thereof will seek out the wisdom. You hear that? And what is wisdom? The fear of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. That's the beginning of wisdom. That's what these people, these punk ass preachers, especially the black church, man, they full of shit anyway. They ain't telling you nothing about fearing Yahweh while Yahweh Shai. They go along to get along, Rodney King ass Israelites, man. Anyway, what will they do? They will seek out the wisdom of all the ancient. See that? And be occupied in what? Prophecies. Be occupied in prophecies. Let's go back and read just a couple more of these. All right. According to Nostradamus, according to the Bible, really. All right. And again, he could have been a prophet. Just, at the last trump. Then again, he could be back too. Matter of fact, he is back. The scripture said third and fourth generation. You come back. And that's a part of it. Another thing wacky techie ass Christians don't teach. They can't understand. They don't got the eye salve, man. You know, the unction from the Holy One. According to Nostradamus, researchers will discover the existence of incredibly deadly what? V-word. You see that? 40,000 years old. And that's bullshit. Okay? Everybody should know by now that the earth ain't no damn 40,000 years old. Esau Edom comes up with all these crazy-ass this dinosaur bone's 100 million years old with trying to do some carbon dating. Y'all are bugged out, man. All right? The earth is no more than 15,000 years old, man. Okay? And that could be proven with the Bible. Anyway, bacteria from the V-word was slowly released into the ocean's waters and glaciers melt, killing many people. Oh, this is crazy, man. Let's see if there's any more I really want to see. Massive earthquakes. Scripture said this too. Didn't it say there shall be earthquakes in diverse places? Didn't it say there shall be wars and rumors of wars? See, all these things have been prophesied already. All right? You know, Scripture said he's going to join Judah and Israel together, one stick in the land of the north. All right? Or the west, if you will, which is what? It's Babylon. It's America. That's where the bulk of the salvation is coming from, man. And I got to say this too, to the four corners of the earth, whether Yahweh Shai scattered us. And see, the first two predicted natural disasters. Yeah, we all know about that, especially here in Western North Carolina, man. Damn. Yahweh Shai destroyed this place. All right. A cataclysmic earthquake. See, Nostradamus pinpointed to occur on the coast of Japan. Wow. That tsunami. Okay. Is there any more I wanted to get? A new king. Woo. I got to read this. Oh, this is going into Prince Harry. Okay. Or, you know, look at these devils. They all demons, too. See, one of the predicted one of the king of the Isles. Let's see. Analysis. Have taken the mean of Prince Harry. No, I don't give a damn none of that. All right. Nostradamus predicted that through the death of a very old pontiff, a Roman of a good age will be elected. Woo! Do you hear that? That sounds like Nero to me, don't it? See, that sounds like Nero, man. All right. That's crazy to see that. And then they equate that to this nigga right here. It's got the crown of his head covered. All right. We already know where that comes from. All these religions come from the Catholic Church anyway. Volcanic eruption. I'll just read it like that. Let's see. China wages war. Wow. Humans will be able to live to 150. And that's part of that AI bullshit, you know, which is really ushering in the MOTB, man. All right. You know, they're trying to merge man and machine together. They show you in all these movies, Transcendence and freaking. There's an old ass movie called The Lawnmower Man, you know, where he uploaded himself into the damn unicorn, right? What was that other movie? Lucy, where she was a part of the internet, you know, straight up. RoboCop. It's all kinds of movies, man. All right? This is crazy. Let's continue on. I'm getting a little bit off track here, but oh, that's interesting. Was that all eight of them? It was probably more than that. Okay. And you know, you got a bunch of bimbos all over the place, whether they're young or old, man. This is prophesied to happen too. All right. You know, wicked women with too much liberty to get abroad, man. It's all in the prophecies. That's why we stay occupied in there. Huh? Jeremiah 28, verse 8. The prophets that have been before me and before thee of old, which was us, prophesied both against many countries and against many kingdoms of war and evil and of pestilence. Hello? Do you not see all this happening? War, evil, pestilence. The scripture said, the days shall be evil. That's why we got to pay attention to these prophecies. Evil. Nothing but evil. When they say peace and safety, sudden destruction. All right? The prophet that prophesieth of peace, when the word of the prophet shall come to pass. Woo! Then shall the prophet be known that the Lord Yahweh have truly sent him. Hear that? Didn't the scripture tell you? Give them warning from me. Tell them. You know, hey, Isaiah 58 verse 1. Cry aloud, spare not, lift up your voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgressions, and the house of Jacob their sins. It didn't say it be all soft and bring a smooth, easy message. Hell no. Yahweh Bashem Yahshua is austere, man. And the prophets, we going to tell you, give you the straight skinny. It is what it is. And we don't give a damn if your feelings get hurt. It don't matter. Okay? You got to be told what the score is. All right? And the score is 144,000 to nothing. That's what's up. Luke 11 and verse 49. This is red letters. Therefore also said the wisdom of the Most High power. I will send them prophets and apostles, and some of them they shall slay and persecute. Do you hear that? Didn't the scriptures very plainly say he knows he has but a short time? That's why it's going to come in like a flood. You see these campaigns, you see these unrighteous decrees and these laws that they're trying to put in the books to try to get rid of the Bible. All right? Yahweh Bashem Yahshua, he said he's going to cause the famine of the word. Okay? All right. They're trying to get rid of the Bible. And you can look, you know, it was this year, 2024, hopeful year of Jacob's trouble. OK. And this is red letters, too. All right. Verse 50, the blood of all the prophets which was shed from the foundation of the world may be required of this generation, from the blood of Abel unto the blood of Zacharias, which perished between. Which perished between the altar and the temple. Verily, I say unto you, it shall be required of this generation. Whew. That's heavy. Woe. What does that mean? Destruction unto you, lawyers, for ye have taken away the key of knowledge. Ye entered not into yourselves, and them that were entering is ye in ye hindered. OK, so we all understand that some of us are going to have to be martyrs, man. Okay, you know, it talks about that. As a matter of fact, I think I got that pulled up. Yeah, it's right here. Here we go. Yeah, the prophets are telling you, man. All right, they're telling you. Revelation 20, verse 4. And I saw thrones as they sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded. Are you fully aware of what's being said right here? All right, for the witness of HaMashiach Yahweh Shai, and for the word of the Most High power, all right, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither the image, neither neither have received his mark upon their foreheads or in their hands. Do you hear that? Huh? That's the MOTB right there. That's the C-Hip in pursuant to Revelation 13. And they lived and reigned with HaMashiach Yahweh Shai 1,000 years. That's beautiful. That's absolutely beautiful. See that? Isaiah 48, verse 11. See, I mean, hey, it is what it is. It is what it is. But the scripture also said there'll be some of you that be standing here right now that will not taste of death. Okay? You know, and I hope I'm a part of that number. Yahweh Rat Dazam, I'm a part of that number, man. You know, that get beamed up, that New Jerusalem coming down, that beautiful clip that was played in the beginning of this epistle. That's that New Jerusalem coming down. New bodies, perfect, man. The city of perfection, man. Isaiah 48, verse 11. This is comforting. All right. For my own sake, I will do it. For how should my name be polluted? You got another camp that's got IUIC on their logo. Oh. And I will not give my glory unto another. That's talking about Israel right there. See? Hearken unto me, O Jacob and Israel, northern and southern kingdom. My called, right? My called. I am he. I am the first. Also, I am the last. Alpha and Omega, man. See that? Reminds me of that song I did a lesson on. It's Alpha and Omega's Kingdom Come, right? That song is awesome, man, by Johnny Cash. I absolutely love it. Call Hello Yahweh Bashem Yahshua. That shit was beautiful, man. Okay? A powerful song, man. I really like that. All right? Let's go here. Acts 4 and verse 10. Be it known unto you all. All right? That's Israelites, and to all, well, that's everybody, Salakia, and to all the people of Israel that by the name of HaMashiach Yahweh Shai of Nazareth, whom ye crucified, whom the Most High raised from the dead, even him doth this man stand before you whole. Whew. That's heavy. Verse 11, this is the stone which was set at naught of you builders, which is become the head of the corner, the chief corner stone. That's Yahweh Shai. All right. Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim, Rakaha Kwadash, man. Through him, there's only one mediator. You understand that? And that's our big brother, Yahweh Shai, man. That's it. And there's no other. Okay. What was that here? Verse 12. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby they must be saved. And that's Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. All right? That's what the name, the Heavenly Father's name, being Yahweh. All right? The King of Israel, the ruler of the universe. Okay? The very same one that you should have a healthy fear of. All right? I got to play this clip. I'm going to play it right here in a second. All right? All right? No other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. And who's that we? It's not everybody. You know? You're just wacky, tacky-ass Christians. We? What do you mean we? You can't even be a Christian not unless you were Israelite in the first place. What you talking about, Willis? You know what I'm saying? Hey, Salaki, here, let me play this clip right quick. Check this out.
With U.S. companies and researchers leading the way, we are on the threshold of virtually unlimited reserves of energy, including from traditional fuels, LNG, clean coal, next generation nuclear power, and gas hydrate technologies. At the same time, I'm proud to report the United States is among the cleanest air and drinking water on Earth. And we're going to keep it that way. And we just came out with a report that at this moment, it's the cleanest it's been in the last 40 years. We're committed to conserving the majesty of God's creation and the natural beauty of our world. Today, I'm pleased to announce the United States will join 1 Trillion Trees Initiative being launched here at the World Economic Forum. 1 Trillion Trees. This is not a time for pessimism. This is a time for optimism. Fear and doubt is not a good thought process, because this is a time for tremendous hope and joy and optimism and action. But to embrace the possibilities of tomorrow, we must reject the perennial prophets of doom and their predictions of the apocalypse. These alarmists always demand the same thing: absolute power to dominate, transform, and control every aspect of our lives. We will never let radical socialists destroy our economy, wreck our country.
He said, all right, you know, and again, he talking about we're going to plant a trillion. You know how he talks, a billion trees. When the scripture said you took peace from the earth, when the wicked are in authority, the people mourn. It's simple. You heard what he said. You know, and these Edomites are full of shit. Now he got a damn a Trump Bible, a damn what they call American Bible, talking about what the damn not the Ten Commandments, Salakia, damn, with the Constitution in it. And wherever you Jakes, wherever you Israelites, when they was writing the Constitution in slavery, my goodness, this is crazy, man. Talking about God bless America when Babylon's gonna be destroyed. Isaiah 33 verse 6. You know, remember now when he said, no, we're going to be, it's going to be good now. It's peace and safety. What is it? The scripture said, sudden destruction. But the wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of that time. He said, there's no need to fear. There's no need to fear. Trump is here. Oh my goodness. Mm-mm-mm. Isaiah 33 verse 6. This is a perfect precept. And what wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. See that? The wisdom and knowledge, that's good news. And who's going to have that wisdom and knowledge? Those who actually fear. You said, you heard what he said. There's no need to fear. Oh, that's the first lesson, is you better fear Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. You better fear. Okay? And knowledge and wisdom shall be the stability of thy times and the strength of salvation. The fear of the Lord Yahweh is his treasure. You hear that? Behold, their valiant ones shall cry without. The ambassadors of peace shall weep bitterly. There's no need to fear. We're going to plant trillions, billions of trees. Okay? With his comb over. Call on Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Nero is back, baby. He's back. Okay? Proverbs 9 and verse 10. Let's read this. The fear of the Lord Yahweh is the beginning of wisdom. What did that say? What did it say? It's in our book of Isaiah 33rd chapter. It said, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of that time. But you can't have it not unless you have a fear of Yahweh. Why Yahweh Shai? This is simple. The fear of the Lord Yahweh is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the holy is understanding. And that word holy means separate. All right. The real true prophets, the prophets of doom. Let's get that scripture. It's going to be nothing but what? Doom and gloom. Doom and gloom. Joel 2 and verse 1. Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, people, before it's a place, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain, the government. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble. That's why they're coming up with these unrighteous decrees and trying to do certain shit. Okay? Let them all tremble. They're going to be surprised at the strangeness of his salvation. Book of Solomon, the fifth chapter. A Song of Solomon, man. Okay? Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord Yahweh cometh, for it is nigh at hand. Scripture said, look up. Your redemption draweth nigh. And that wasn't talking about everybody. Let's read it. Verse 2, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness. As what? It said what? A day of darkness and gloominess. He said, well, don't worry about it. You don't have to have any fear of anything. We're Americans. Huh? And he's just a puppet anyway. I'm telling you, you better listen up, Israel. All right? Yeah, that's right, brother. GMS Inland Empire 2. The jig is up, man. It's up. Son of perdition has been revealed. All right? A day of darkness. Verse 2, a day of darkness and of gloominess, a day of clouds and of thick darkness. As the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people, a strong, there have not been ever since like, neither shall be any more after it, even to the years of many generations. Let's read what's going to happen. A fire, what? Fire devoureth before them, and behind them a flame burneth. The land is as the Garden of Eden, Salakia. Before them and behind them a desolate wilderness, yea, and nothing shall escape. Leave them neither root nor branch. They're going to run upon the housetops and the windows. I'm talking about the ICBMs, all right? That's going to be shot off from every nation that's capable of doing it. Because the nations are mad. They slept with the great whore, a.k.a. America. Found out she was a hoe. See that? So at some point, Tom, this hoe is going to, her thighs are going to get uncovered. And that's what we're doing right now. Shit. It's right here in the scriptures. Verse 4, the appearance of them is as the appearance of horses and as horsemen. So they run like the noise of chariots on the tops of the mountains. So shall they leap like the noise of a flame of fire that devoureth the stubble, as a strong people set in battle array. Man, I read this before. You can get burned the hell up. Let's go right here. And all these damn, and all of a sudden, these conservatives and whoever talking about they Christians. All of a sudden, they are Jesus freaks, man. I don't even like to even say it. I don't even like to say that word. Because that damn sure ain't his name. All right? Talking about the Son of the Most High, the only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai. Okay? Coming out with Bibles, and you got, what's that devil's name? And I grew up with his damn grandchildren. Started a Samaritan's Purse. What's that demon's name? Shit. Graham. Them damn Grahams. And I can tell you right. Matter of fact, I did a lesson some years back. I showed you the pictures of them fools, man. You know, they was demons too. Nothing but dirty ass Edomites. You're talking about a national prayer for Trump and for America, man. Fuck America, man. Okay, let's get it on. And then you got him, Trump, holding up a Bible upside down, which is, you know, that's an omen, if you will. Talking about 1 Corinthians or 2 Corinthians. Oh, my goodness. You weak-ass, punk-ass Christians, man. You can't see and you can't tell that shit is fake as hell. It's because you fake as hell, man. You don't have the Holy Spirit. You don't have an unction from the Holy One. 2 Corinthians. Shh. Give me a break. Y'all crazy, man. Y'all bug the hell out. 1 Thessalonians 5:3. For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them, as travaileth upon a woman with child, and they shall what? Not escape. They ain't nowhere to run to, like that old song. Ain't nowhere to run to, baby, and ain't nowhere to hide. You can dwell up under them rocks and let the rocks fall upon you, but when that new Jerusalem comes down, your ass is grass, and that's that. Hopefully this lesson was edifying, giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rekah HaKodesh. Salvation is for Israel and Israel only. Matter of fact, 2/3 got to go. Huh? Healthy shalom to the brothers that are out there doing the work in truth and sincerity. All right. Double honors to the men at Great Millstone, whom I learn from each and every day. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Let's go. Yeah, every chance you get, chant this place down. Kwam Yasharala and Wa Abba Ba. Boom. Shalom.